Warning, this video contains the sound of cicadas mating. If you are easily offended, please do not listen. You have been warned.
Whenever you're trying to change a habit in your life, you have to commit yourself to the process of rebuilding certain aspects of your life after the habit has gone from your life. I'm Kevin O'Hara for habitsunplugged.com. So a lot of habit change means getting rid of something, right? Eliminating one part of your life, the parts that you don't want anymore, and rebuilding what's left, you know, the gaps in your life with something else, right? Rebuilding new habits, new behaviors, new rituals, new ways of doing things, which are much more conducive to the person that you want to be, to the behaviors that you want to see in your life, to the end results that you want to achieve, right? And in order to do that, you have to follow a certain process, you know, that there is a certain process to rebuilding. And when you get rid of an old habit, there's not much more you can do about the old habit itself rather than just stopping doing it, right? So to quit drinking, you need to stop the drinking. To quit smoking, you need to stop the smoking. To get rid of a certain parts of a bad lifestyle, like not exercising, you need to exercise, right? And you need to get rid of slovenly, you need to sort of get rid of procrastination as much as you can. You know, the process of getting from where you are to where you want to be, you know, from A to B, starts out with the initial changing of the guard, right? So you eliminate one thing, you eliminate what you want to get rid of, and you start building what you want to build, right? And that whole process of building is dynamic, right? It changes all the time, but it's going from A to B, right? So a lot of people, when they quit smoking, for instance, or stop drinking, they expect everything to change, right? They expect once they stop the drinking that there is no more work involved. Well, this is where most people become disillusioned, because quitting smoking or quitting drinking is just the start of the process, right? Fair enough, you've got rid of a bad situation, right? You've got rid of a bad behavior in your life, and that is going to lead you into much better decisions with much better behaviors in the long term. But you have to take action on rebuilding something else, right? It's almost like somebody looking up at a mountain and wanting to get to the top of the mountain without actually doing the climb, right? And it's in the climb itself where you'll get the most benefits. So, you know, there are ways and means of getting to the top of the mountain. You could hire a helicopter and the helicopter can fly you to the top of the mountain. You can get to the top of the mountain by being carried up by a donkey. You can get to the top of the mountain by, if you've got enough money, building a cable car and getting to the top that way, right? You can build an escalator up beside the mountain and, you know, however, you know, what that might cost. But at the end of the day, it's part of the journey, part of the dynamics of this journey, and part of the journey of habit change, which requires that you actually physically climb the mountain, you know. Now consider a relationship, right? A relationship where somebody starts out with a single date, right? It might start out with a single smile in a conversation, and then it leads on to a date and so on and so forth. You don't go from meeting somebody and getting married to them the next day, you know. Well, most sane people don't anyway. It requires a lot of work in between, you know, a lot of to-ing and fro-ing, a lot of getting to know each other, buying flowers and going to the movies and going on different dates and going to restaurants and, you know, doing stuff like that. So there is a process involved in it. And for most long-term stable relationships, they require that process to be gone through first, you know, to see if you're suitable to eat for each other, for a start. You know, it's the same as weight loss. I mean, if you want to lose weight, you can't just get from A to B. You've got to go through the whole process of losing weight. You've got to go through the discomfort of going without food. You've got to go through the discomfort of learning and teaching your body how to enjoy exercise at whatever level you want to do it. And you've got to have a balance between the two, right? So calories in, calories out. You know, less calories coming in, more calories going out means that you're going to lose the weight. And this is a process that is done over time. Get too impatient with this process and you're likely to derail it. So just understand that the whole thing, no matter what habit you're trying to get rid of or what habit you're trying to build, requires a process. You've got to understand the basic principles of that process before you even start, because otherwise you're going to go around in circles. And then once you understand those and you put your principles and processes into practice, then you've got to stick out the process and follow the process if you want to get to the end, right? You know, if you decide you want to lose weight and you don't cut down on food, but you know, do a lot of exercise, and then you're unlikely to lose weight, you know. It needs to be balanced on both ends of the scale. You know, you need to understand the process before you can do anything else. So get with the process. Now, this process works. These processes work in the exact opposite way as well, you know. I mean, there's a process of becoming habituated to drinking or to smoking or to getting fat or to procrastinating or to getting shit at your job, you know, going from being good to, you know, just allowing bad habits to crawl into certain parts of your life. I mean, this is a process. It starts out very simple, accumulates certain bad behaviors and bad rituals, and they all accumulate into bad habits, and those bad habits can accumulate into a pretty disastrous life, you know, if you let it go. So, you know, either way, your body is going to go through an habitual process one way or another. It's just up to you to figure out how you're going to do it. No matter where it is that you're going on this journey, no matter what you're trying to achieve, what habit you're trying to get rid of, or what habit you're trying to build in your life, just remember the process. You know, try and familiarize yourself with your individual process before you start, right? And to follow that process as you go along. I mean, a lot of the processes that you're going to find yourself going through as you go on this journey are going to change, but don't be afraid of allowing that process to evolve and to develop as you go through, right? So I'll leave it there for today. If you have any questions or any comments at all, leave them down below in the comment section, or come on over to habitsunplugged.com. And remember that there are three P's to effective habit change. There's perseverance, there is patience, and there is positivity, right? So take care of yourself. Have a great day. Until next time, I'm Kevin O'Hara for Habits Unplugged. Onwards and upwards, eh? Take care. Bye-bye now.